What in the world? When? Why? Where? Who's got the answer? Skunk Bear.
Twitter user Bookie McReaderpants asks, why can't I power my home using a bicycle-powered generator?
That's a good question.
Good question.
To look for answers, I'm here in Rochester, New York. This place used to be the bike capital of America. It even had a national magazine about bike paths. And it's the home of University of Rochester astrophysicist, blogger, and NPR contributor Adam Frank. He's gonna help us figure things out. Hey, Adam.
Hey, Adam, how's it going? So the first question is, how much energy does my house use anyway? I mean, there's the lights, the air conditioner,
the microwave, the dryer,
the refrigerator,
the water heater.
And it all adds up to about 900 kilowatt hours every month.
So where does that energy come from?
Coal burned at this Rochester power plant, and water that turns the turbines at this hydro station on the Genesee River. Could Adam here generate that energy instead? After all, before the Industrial Revolution, we all depended on the power of humans and animals.
So let's get set up. Adam's legs turn the wheel. The wheel hooks up to the generator and turns that motion into electricity. And that electrical energy is stored in the battery so that I can use it later on, even when Adam isn't pedaling. Now, if Adam's gonna power my house, just like that power plant, he's gonna need some fuel.
This is the garbage plate, a Rochester delicacy. It contains about as much energy as a cup of gasoline, roughly 2 kilowatt hours.
Unfortunately, Adam's not a very efficient machine. He can only convert about a quarter of the fuel he eats into energy. And some of that energy is just going to, you know, keeping him alive. His lungs breathing, his heart beating, his digestive system digesting. With the energy that's left, an elite cyclist can generate about 0.4 kilowatts for an hour. But Adam, he's not an elite cyclist. And I need him to go for a lot longer than an hour. If he pedals for 8 hours a day, the best he's gonna be able to maintain is about a quarter of what the elite cyclist can do. And that sums up to about 1 kilowatt hour per day.
That would be enough to keep this lamp going. But
remember, our whole system, it's inefficient. Some of that energy gets lost on its way through the generator, and some on the way from the generator down to the battery. So at the end of the day, there's only about a half of a kilowatt hour in the battery. If he pedals all day for a month, scarfing down 120 garbage plates, he'll store away a grand total of 16 kilowatt hours.
The same amount of energy in half a gallon of gasoline.
Remind me, how much does your house need again?
900 kilowatt hours per month.
It would take 50 atoms pedaling over time to power my house. And it would take the entire population of New York City to power every house and business in Rochester.
And that, Bookie McReaderpants, is why you can't power your house with a bicycle.
Ask Skunk Bear more questions here and subscribe to our channel to follow the answers.
And you can ask me questions on Twitter at AdamFrank4 or listen to NPR for more short answers to big questions.